bicycle, bicycle, bicycle.
I want to ride my
bicycle, bicycle, bicycle.
This video is part of my bike commuting in Lexington series. Today I'm going to go from my neighborhood, which is the Picadome neighborhood, down to the public library, Central Library, downtown Lexington. Come join me. I start in the Picadome neighborhood. I make my way down to Rosemont Garden. And there is some construction going on Rosemont Garden, so I have to be vigilant about that. And of course, you never know exactly what you're going to encounter on your trip, so just be aware. By now, that construction is over and everything has been nicely fixed, except if you look down to the right between the curb and the bike path, every so often you will see gaps there. These have not been fixed. And so when you take this bike road and you're going towards Nicholasville Road, you have to be very vigilant about the gaps. They could cause an accident. So you're riding on Rosemont Garden and eventually you will be coming past some construction vehicles, as you do here. That's of course not the norm, but like I said, you have to be prepared for everything. Here we're going, we've just passed Rosemont Station and Paitana on the right, two neighborhood restaurants that we normally, my husband and I, walk to. You cross the railroad tracks. I get stuck at the railroad tracks very often. It's a very busy rail line. So you make your way through this very nice residential neighborhood towards Nicholasville Road. And on Nicholasville Road, we're going to turn left to go very briefly on Nicholasville Road and then immediately turn right onto Hiltonia, which takes you past the hospital. And there are a couple of cutouts. If you need to let some cars go by because they're getting impatient behind you. At the top, you turn left, and you have to be careful as you're going through this area here because there might be ambulances, patients walking across, people turning left and right. There's also a parking garage, and sometimes people are shooting at this parking garage. You'll be turning right and take this little bike path here, and then at the bottom you have to be very careful because sometimes there are buses and passenger vehicles coming from the right. So you take this road here, which goes past the student housing. It would be a nice road, except it's very uneven. It really needs to be repaved. And then you come to this roundabout. There are two ways to take the roundabout. One of them is just to be part of the traffic, and the other one is to become a pedestrian and cross at the pedestrian crossways. I usually do the traffic ones. I find this simply more convenient. Now we're on University Drive, and as you're going towards the library, you have to be careful with buses on the right. And then you also have to be careful with cars that are parked on the right. I usually go very far on the left just in case somebody decides to open the door. The markings around University of Kentucky are very good for bikers, but you also compete in that space with people riding scooters. So just be aware and keep looking at your rearview mirror to make sure that you know what's coming up behind you. It's a beautiful road. Sometimes very busy, sometimes not so busy. Today it seems to be quite busy, but it is tree-lined and that makes it just a very pleasant ride. Once you cross over here, again, more cars parked on the right-hand side. And on that particular day, as I'm riding through the campus, it turns out that the campus is getting ready for drop-off day. So a little bit further ahead, you're going to see markings again. So it's going to be a little bit confusing, but you just have to be prepared for those kinds of things propping up. When you ride through the campus, you also have to be aware that there are crosswalks and students have the right of way in the crosswalks. So now we're coming up towards the area where parts traffic is being regulated for drop-off. I'm right now in the right-hand lane, but I will have to move into the left-hand lane, which I will be doing shortly. And then I'll be going straight as I'm coming up to the university library. So just beyond here, I'm going to be turning into the left lane. And you can see the library up ahead, and here is one of the crosswalks that I was mentioning earlier. While I am in the left-hand lane, I won't actually be turning left. I'll be going diagonal across Hilltop Lane, and we'll be turning onto campus to go past the library and then down towards Columbia. When you cross campus, you always have to be careful with pedestrians not paying any attention. Students very often have headsets on or earbuds, and they won't be able to hear you. So you need to be very careful and alert as you're going through here to make sure that you don't cause an accident. So down here then, we're turning left onto Columbia. And just up ahead, right here, we'll be turning right onto Rose. There's a bike lane, but you can tell that the pavement is very uneven, and I usually ride in the road because it's just very unpleasant to be riding in the area reserved for bikes. There's a traffic light coming up, and here you want to be very careful because the bike lane, of course, is on the right, but cars can turn right. So you either go ahead of the cars or you stay behind the cars. Or at any rate, that is what I do for my own safety. Here we have a shared road, and we'll be coming up to another traffic light. That one is going to be, I think, Maxwell. And at that traffic light, I recommend moving when the pedestrian light turns green. There's always a little bit of a delay between the pedestrian light and the traffic light for cars. And if you're in the bike lane and the pedestrian light turns green and you go at that point, then you're going to be ahead of all the cars. And particularly when there's so many cars in the left lane, this allows you to claim your road. It's a question of safety. And then once you're past that, you can move to the right and people can pass you. So down here, there is a left turn lane. All these cars are turning left, but I'll be going straight. So beyond that traffic light, I will be turning left. So I'm moving into the left lane, crossing Vine Street over here, and then I'll be going into the left lane to turn left onto Main Street. So I get the yellow arrow, and of course the bike lane is on the right-hand side, but the library is on the left-hand side. So there are a couple of traffic lights on this road, and they will work towards your favor. So the first one here, I'm being caught at the red light, no problem. And then at the second one, it is turning yellow as I'm going through, and I'm going through, but the cars behind me will stop at the red, and that will then give me the opportunity to cross these three lanes and make it over to the library. So you see here, it's turning yellow, cars behind me stop, I cross the lanes, and over here, I move on to the sidewalk, which is legal in Lexington, and make my way towards the front of the library where there are racks to put my bike. And that is the ride. To go to the public library downtown, the central library, I start in my neighborhood. I go turn left onto Rosemont Garden. I cross Nicholasville Road, go up Hiltonia, and then do a little jig and turn left to go past the hospital and past university housing. I cross alumni, I cross Cooper, I come up to the university, skirt the library. Here I'm crossing Hilltop, I'm skirting the library, then I turn left on Columbia, right on Rose Street, and then I go down to Main Street, and that takes me to the library.